Hi everybody, in this tutorial today we will work on JavaScript function. Okay, it is a beginner tutorial I think you guys, and it will be very useful to you those are shifting from C and C++. Okay, let me open my Visual Studio for writing JavaScript function. Okay, so our today's topic is function, if you can say function. So at first you have to know what is a function. Okay, if I want to give a definition here, function is a block of code. Okay, I can say block of code perform a particular task. Okay, particular task, that means suppose I want to add two numbers and I have to take two input from the user and I have to add this two number, and if I need to again add two number, then I have to again write a multiple lines of code to add this number. Okay, or if you are doing a big project, if you want to use every function, if you want to do every task without using a function, then it will be a huge code, or it is not the efficient way. Okay, so you have to divide your program into a function, and when you need this type of function, you need to call this function. Okay, I think that it is not clear to you. Suppose I am taking input from I am declaring two variable and I am taking input from user. Okay, you know the percent, this percent is a typecasting keyword. It basically converts my prompt input as integer. Okay, first number, enter first number. Okay, suppose I'm taking input from the user, and then I'd like to copy this will be. Okay, let me check my video is either going or not. Okay, it is recording. And I am taking two input from user. Okay, and I would like to add this input in my C variable A plus B. Okay, and I want to write this in my document. document.write c. okay, this is how I will take two number and add this in C. And suppose I am saving this, and if I want to run this code, as you know, I have integrated this JavaScript in this HTML, and I will like to open this in my live server. If you don't know what is live server, please see my earlier video. I am giving first number 5 and second number 6. It is printing the element, the add result of my program. Okay, so now what if I need this line of code again in somewhere of my project, then what should I do? Should I take this input again and then again execute this line of code? No way. Just I have to use a function. Suppose what is function? Just you have to define function add. Okay, you can give any name of this of your function, and this is your body to execute when you are calling function. Okay, suppose you would like to take two input A and B, you can give any name to variable, and you would like to execute this line of code in between in the function. Okay, you would like to add you would like this A and B is the you can change this X and Y. Okay, you are taking two input X and Y, and you are adding this two input X and Y in and storing this XY addition C and printing C. Okay, so and then suppose Then and this function will be called when you will call this function. Yet I am not calling this function. Suppose I am calling this function add, and I am giving this input a and b. Okay, let's see what happen. It will first come here, and it will ask to input a and b, and it will pass this value a and b, and a will pass in x and b will pass in y, and then x and y will be will contain the a value of a and b, and it will be stored as a addition value in c, and it will write okay. Save this, and let's see. It is asking for me the number 4. I am giving 4 and 6, and it is printing 10. And then again, suppose if I again call this function, it will automatically again print my value twice. Okay, 3, 4 is printing 7, 7. Why 7, 7? Again 4, 5. 99. It is actually I am not updating the value of c. It is all the time it is adding the number in c, and my c value is getting increased. Okay, so every time after printing I have to make my variable c 0. Let's see what happens if I giving up to 4 and 5, it is printing 99. 5 and 6, 111. Okay, I have to make, I have to give this 5, 6. I have to load this code again. Run this code again. Okay. Okay. 5, 6. What the hell? Actually, I didn't define this C. Okay. I have to define this C actually. Var C. Var C is equal to 0, and then it will add. Okay. And then control save. Let me check it is working well or not. 5, 6. 7, 8. Okay, all the time it is just adding. Let me again run my piece of code. Control save. And open with live server. 7, 7, 1414. But why it is not using all the previous result? I'm not getting this. Okay, it is now working well. Let's check it. If I give him as input 6 and 7, it is printing 13 as my output. Okay, but if I don't want to take input from my user, just I have to pass the value static 3, 9. Okay, then control save, you will see 12. And now this time this is not asking from me for the input. This is how we can call a function, or we can define function, or we can pass value into a function. Actually, this function is very important in any kind of programming. We will see later some complex program, complex use of function or recursion, etc., etc. Till now, till then, goodbye.